back in mind and E3 flow through the other valves in the system. The idea is that you always make sure that before you use any valve, you always understand which valve you need first. They need to be properly labeled. This is labeled vacuum, this is labeled main drain. The vacuum, if this valve is in line with the piping, it is flow. For all other valves in this pump, or in the most all valves, when the valve is in line with the pipe, it's open, and when it's perpendicular to the pipe, it's actually closed. So, this system, you always vacuum, you always open before you close the valve. You do not turn the pump off, the pump is still running. So you open the vacuum valve, you give it about 5 to 10 seconds to allow the water to start moving through the vacuum line, so the vacuum is working out at the pool, but it is not pulling very well to the point that you would actually be able to vacuum the pool in a time-efficient manner. So you need to pull back on the main drain in order to increase flow through the vacuum line. But you will only be able to do it to a point. So for you, if you start to move your valve, start closing it slowly. So if you get to the halfway position, and what happens at that point in time is you can start to hear a change in the pump. Struggling to a certain extent in order to get the water that needs through here, because it has to work harder. In normal circumstances, in normal operation, that's not ideal because it puts stress on the pump. In this circumstance, it's fine because you're only doing it for a short period of time. So what you're doing is allow that to the main drain to dial that halfway, and I'm still maintaining fine. What I don't want to happen is I don't want to dial it back so far that I actually lose prime. Look inside the pump now, it's not filled with water 100%. Not 100% filled. If I dial it back to where I had it at the halfway position, it fills back up completely with water. You still want your pump to run with 100% water. You just want to get the most out of it that you can so that your pump is still running at 100% efficiency, but you have as much water going through the vacuum line as possible. This will make vacuum can change, depending on the size of the pool, can change vacuum in the pool for an hour and a half, or 2 hours, 2.5 hours, depending on how much debris you have inside the water. When you're doing this, it's really important to just double check real quick and look at your scope of your pressure gauges on your pump. It's normal if the pump is having to work a little bit harder to get the water to go through, because the way you set things up here for your pressure to go down a little bit. That is perfectly fine. But it needs to maintain steady. Normal pressure is 5 to 6 in this pool, about 16 psi or so. Right now it's sitting, I can see from here about 12 psi, which is perfectly fine because it's going steady. And you can look back in here, and since we've actually put everything back, it's running back at 100% efficiency. So we're in an ideal position is what I'm saying. So at this point in time, we're going to continue back out on the deck.